I'm going to play a video. And we have a special video that was just made for you guys. And this has a special place in my heart because I've known this gentleman for a little while now out of Houston, Texas. This gentleman has the best attitude you'll ever see. But dealing with one of the most severe diseases in the world. So let's go ahead and play the video, and then I want to bring Mr. Sykes up for a testimony on what Kyan has done to him to change his life. So let's go ahead and roll the video, please.
So we moved to Denver. We were there for 12 years, and it was a blessing. We became enthusiasts for the outdoors, of course. You had to be. So I became a big mountain biker, hiker. Of course, you really have to work out for those, so they're just pretty strenuous. And I always loved being in shape, waking up at 5:30 in the morning to do it. In 2013, I was working out one day, doing yoga, and I could not do some of the balance poses, just one day out of the blue. And I'll never forget it because I got so mad at myself. I'm sitting there, I'm going, come on, get your balance. And it was so frustrating. And it just kind of progressed. More and more I did it, the more it got worse. And I really was getting to the point where I was running and tripping because I couldn't keep my feet up. And 2014 was the official diagnosis, but I was feeling it in 13.
I'm Laura Sykes. I'm Stephen's wife. We've been married for almost 25 years. And we met in high school. We were high school sweethearts and got married in college. Everything seemed to be pretty normal. And then he was diagnosed, and it was just a huge shock. Neither of us could believe it. And you know, I mean, when you get diagnosed, they tell you 3 to 5 years. And it's kind of like, wait a second, you know, we've known each other for more than half of our lives, and we're facing this together. There was a period where he stopped working. Things were real tough to know kind of what's going to happen next. When you get something like ALS and they give you kind of a short time frame to live, you think things are just going to keep going and they're going to be the same. But all of a sudden, this hits you. And at first, it's devastating. And you don't really know how to react or what to do. But then you get this renewed energy of, yeah, life is so precious. Let's take advantage of what we've got. When he found Keani, it was like this light bulb went on again in him. And he found kind of renewed energy and something new to look forward to. The cool thing was is he got to reach out to a lot of people, and I think it gave him the opportunity to share his story of having ALS and being able to reach out to him, but then also having something to give them hope with.
I joined Keani in November of 2016, and Keani was introduced to me by my mom. So, you know, you gotta listen to your mother. And I saw a change that I had never seen before in her, and she became a much better person. And when I saw that, I never forget it, she called me up for lunch, and I went, this is my mom calling me for lunch? And she had really turned around how she felt, how she was doing. And 2 weeks, I was really able to think clearer. I was able to process things better. And I was able to actually not have to take a nap in the afternoon. Anywhere I go now, they ask me to talk or say something. And I would have never done that before. You know?
Yeah.
And that's been something interesting to me with Keani, with her business. They really train and develop their people.
Yeah. Another thing I wanted to laugh about, you were like, at the very beginning, you go,
I learned how to pronounce this, Kiani. And then at the end, you're like, yeah, Kiani.
I know. Yeah. We were talking about that, the car driving over here.
My name is Dave Shaw, and I've known Steven Sykes for about 12 years. We used to work together, and I remember probably about 4 years ago, Steven had commented on some physical changes and challenges that you were having, but could never really put a finger on what it was, because Steven had always been and still always is very focused on health and fitness. I mean, and to me, I was really shocked. He was not your average bear, like really into fitness and health and family and God. And he wasn't the kind of guy that I thought that would be levied with that illness. So yeah, it was more of a shock. And to hear today that he's so invested in Kiani doesn't surprise me, because he's always been the guy that is focused on health, but also focused on others. That's the one thing that I've always been impressed with Steven. He's very mindful, respectful, and he's all about family and first guy to help somebody else.
So if I had to describe Kiani in three different words, I would describe him as being about relationships. I describe it as being something simple that anyone could do. And I would describe it as sharing. I was reading off one of the slides that talks about where Dr. Q, or what it was talking about, all three ingredients, none is better than the other one. And when I said that, the way he says it, I told everybody in the crowd, I said, you know, that's exactly how our team is no one is better than anyone else. And together, though, we create that real triangle.
I'm Lorraine Sykes, and I'm Steven Sykes's mother.
He just has a positive attitude all the time. I know he has his down moments, but I never see him down. He's always positive, and he just keeps going and, just doing the best he can, just living one day at a time. And that's inspiration to us. If he was down and depressed, we would be too. But when we see, he's never down, and we just go, wow, we don't have anything to complain about. And, you know, when he started with Kiani, that just kind of gave him a boost and just gave him something to look forward to each day. So, yeah, he's been our inspiration, you know.
One thing I love as far as what we do is we do build relationships. Never, ever count anyone out. Never judge. You really never know who is going to be receptive. You never know what people need until you ask. And then it's very simple to share it. And whether they're going to be receptive and do it, or you're at least going to plant the seed and they're going to think about you later. So I really see a huge importance as far as if you're in Kiani to, we always call it sharing the product, but it's really more than that. You're actually sharing your story. It might not be yours, it could be someone else that you know, but share your story. Make sure they understand what the story is about and how it can maybe relate to them, and then also build that relationship. Because once you have a connection, it's amazing what you can do and help people out. If there's any doubt, any problem, and that quit word comes in your head, just remember, go out there and help someone else. If you go out and help someone else, no matter how little, how small, I can promise you your problems will go away. And you'll be able to understand really what it means to have a relationship and share. My name is Steven Sykes, and I live Kiani.
Please help welcome to the stage Mr. Steven Sykes. If we could get a microphone to the front, please, a microphone. Screaming like never before. Baby, I like it. I like it. are you, brother? Good seeing you. I'm going to get a microphone.
Girl, please excuse me if I'm misbehaving. Oh, I'm trying to keep my hands off, but you're begging me for more. Round, 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 baby, low, low, low. The time
Thank you so much. I should not be here today. That's right. 3 years ago, they told me I wasn't going to be here. And I am here today. And when you get a rare and deadly disease put on your back, you need caregivers. And my wife and my mom take care of me and help me every day. And so I need them to be at their best. Never, ever forget about a caregiver. And they are on Kiani. I remember from your newborn, your about newborn, you know, baby now helps me out a little bit. Kiani, and they're on it. And it has helped them take care of me. And that is huge. That is just so big for someone like me. And to have, Mr. Bradford here see me as who I am, such a little amount of time, and to send someone out so I can do the one thing I really wanted to do. And that is to impact lives. If I can help everyone here be a purple diamond, then that would be awesome. Use the stories that are there and make sure people know how important it is, because your circle of influence of everyone here is so important. We cannot let people go away that have a circle of influence that might touch me. And the person that brought me here, she's actually still here today. Sarah, and I thank you. Never quit. I say that every day when I get out of bed. I want to stand up every day. Never quit. Thank you for having me. And I live Kiani.